Oracle cards are really cool because they are an easy and kind of fun way to get in touch with our own intuition. But really, they can become a distraction and they can cause us to rely on them as something external to ourselves, when in reality, the innate ability to understand and perceive and to really feel what direction we should go in lies within us. And while, you know, I like to use Oracle cards, I don't use them a ton just because I tend to rely upon my own inner wisdom and my own inner voice. And if I do use Oracle cards or tarot cards, it's usually to get some further clarity or to see if we've got some validating ideas that are coming through from spirit. Also, just so that you know, I'm just a woman on the internet. I'm just an intuitive person on the internet. You never want to put your trust too much in someone else. You always want to be finding ways to get back to the truth about you. We were just up in the Lightworkers Lab last night, which is my online community on Facebook. And if you don't know about it, well, you better know. You better know. It's fun. We've got over 8,000 people in there. We've got a lot of teachers and practitioners. They give free readings, healings. It's cool. All free to members. But I was just up last night and we were talking about how important it is to understand how powerful you are and how unnecessary some of these accoutrements actually are to our own manifestation. Like, we came here to create. We came here to manifest. We came here to do something powerful with our lives. And we have everything within us to do that. Now, is it all activated at this time? Not necessarily. Some of us haven't really found our path or found our purpose yet. But once we do, once we really feel that excitement with our purpose and our passion, and we move in the direction of that, that's when all of these abilities and resources begin to activate, because we brought them with us into this life. As a spiritual teacher and as somebody who's had many clients and I've mentored people, my ultimate goal is to always get them to mentor themselves and to rely on themselves. Again, Oracle cards are fun. They're a little doorway, but they're really just an access point to help you become familiar with how you feel spirit messages, which is why at the very beginning of this broadcast, I said, pay attention to what's coming through. When you first start working with your intuition, it can be quite subtle, because spirit never wants to barge in and rattle you, or worse, to frighten you. So spirit just starts giving you some quiet information. Sometimes it sounds like your own voice. Sometimes it feels like your own feelings, but there's just a little bit of a different energy to it, a more meaningful energy to it. But if you don't pay attention to how it works for you, then you're never going to recognize when spirit is trying to give you a message. So doing these types of exercises or working in this way, paying attention to what's going on, helps you to figure out for yourself how it feels when spirit is trying to work with you. Now, I will say, if you want to work with spirit in a very evidential way, meaning with evidences, you want to tell spirit that. You want to actually declare that and speak that out. See, as a man speaks, so he is. As a woman speaks, so she is. And so you actually want to say, I want that deeper connection. I want more signs. I want more information. I want the resources I need to connect with you, spirit, in a deeper or on a higher level. Anytime we ask spirit to give us the tools that we need to make that deeper communion, they always come through. However, we have to make sure that on our end, we're paying attention, because the resources come in unconventional ways. Sometimes information is given through patterns and synchronicities. Sometimes knowledge and truth comes in the form of somebody that we meet or a book that we have access to. And if we're not really paying attention to all the different ways that we can receive this information and this guidance, well, then we miss the majority of it. It's never spirit's fault that we can't hear spirit. It's all, and there's no fault, but it's not spirit's fault. It's not that spirit is doing something wrong. It's usually that we aren't open enough, or we have fears around that, or we aren't paying attention and noticing and feeling and then understanding what that means. So I just want to empower you to be your own oracle. I want to empower you to be your own intuitive channel and reader, because it's all within you.